Hello friends, this is Pastor Naveen Karunanidhi and you are watching Inspiration. Today I want to talk to you about do not fear coronavirus. There is something that I want to tell you how to face this coronavirus. And when we talk about how to face coronavirus, the number one thing is do not fear coronavirus. Yes, my friends, when I say do not fear coronavirus, I'm not telling you to be foolish. I'm not saying that you must remove your mask or stop sanitizing yourself and maintain social distancing. I'm not talking about those things. These are physical aspects, and God has given us wisdom and not foolishness. He has given us a sound mind, so we should be led by wisdom and not foolishness. But what I'm talking to you about is the fear factor. Yes, I'm talking to you about the state of your heart and your mind. Yes, anyone could be infected with coronavirus, believers, non-believers. It's absolutely possible because this is a virus and it could come into any human body. But the point is, you must know that if you are a believer of Jesus Christ, you don't need to fear coronavirus. Yes, absolutely. You know, why do I say that? Because, dear friends, when you read the Bible, Jesus revealed that every sickness in the Gospels were associated with a spirit. Yes, you heard it right. There is a demonic spirit behind every sickness, every disease. Or at least it could be a sin that is playing as an open door for sickness to enter. Foolishness could be a reason why sickness could enter. But we read in Acts chapter 10 verse 38, that the Lord Jesus Christ went about healing and delivering all those who were oppressed by the devil. That means everything Jesus did in the Gospels, there was the hand of the devil behind it. And in most cases, we see Jesus rebuking a spirit, and which in turn becomes a healing manifested in somebody's body. In one case, Jesus forgave a man's sin and he was immediately healed. So every sickness has the hand of the devil behind it. Now coming to coronavirus, the Bible says in John chapter 10 verse 10 that the enemy comes to steal, kill and destroy, but Jesus came to give us abundant life. Hallelujah. But you see, the devil comes to steal, kill and destroy. The thief comes to steal, kill and destroy. So when the corona wave came, we saw that it stole people's time, it stole people's money, it stole people's health and stole people's life. Eventually, it comes to steal, kill and destroy. And where there is steal, kill and destroy, you know that it is the thief, the enemy, the devil behind it. Coronavirus is an instrument of the devil. Now, once we have identified who the enemy is, it's very easy to deal with him. Now, dear friends, I want you to know that you don't have to fear coronavirus. If you are a believer of Jesus Christ, you and I know that Satan is under our feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, rejoice with me and say, Satan is under our feet. Yes, demons are under our feet. Witchcraft is under our feet. Sickness and diseases are under our feet. Infections and viruses are under our feet. Hallelujah. Poverty and failure is under our feet. Amen. That is why in Christ Jesus, we have a better place. We have been seated with Christ in the heavenly places with Christ Jesus, which is a seat and a place far above all principality, powers and might and dominion. Amen. That means Satan is way below your status. Hallelujah. Satan is way below your status and my status in Christ, because we are seated with Jesus. Amen. See, the human body that we have is not born again, as our inner man, the spirit, which is born again. Therefore, this human body is waiting to receive the glorious body that Christ would give us in His second coming. That means this is not a body that is born again, and hence it is able to contact infections or diseases or anything that is in the world. Whatever is in the world can affect this body. But thanks be to God, what is inside this body is a born again spirit where God dwells. Hallelujah. That is why you don't have to fear coronavirus the way others would fear coronavirus. Why? Because you have God inside of you. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So You have the capacity, you and I have the privilege to exercise faith and bring out the inner healing power, the inner glory onto our body, inside out. Amen. So we read this in Romans chapter 8, where the Bible says, the same Spirit that raised Christ from dead dwells inside of you and me. And that same Spirit is vitalizing our human body. Amen. So you have the Holy Spirit in you, just as I have the Holy Spirit in me. And this is the Spirit that raised Christ Jesus from the dead. Amen. Now, if you can pray, and if you can confess the right things, and if you can believe with your heart, pretty soon you will see that the life of Jesus within you will vitalize your body. Amen. And another thing to remember is Satan has been defeated 2,000 years back on the cross. We read in the book of Colossians that Satan was made naked, he was beaten, and he was defeated by the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And if there is a sin problem, the blood of Jesus Christ is awaiting to cleanse you, if only you could confess your sins and repent and get rid of it today. God's forgiveness will come upon you and that healing flow will begin. Amen. Now, dear friends, let's face it. Coronavirus can come to anybody. That's all right. But the number one thing is the enemy, the devil, waits for an open door. All right. Now, fear is the biggest door that the enemy waits for. Now, it could be just an infection or it could just be a fever. There could be some symptoms in your body. That's all right. Now you begin to confess the word of God and declare upon yourself the healing power of Jesus and say that I am healed in Jesus' name. And every fever, every symptom, every sickness, every virus, my lungs and throat be healed in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and confess that. Take your medicines and you will be healed. That's it. But the problem is when you begin to fear this virus. Now, most of the time, the fear comes because of what we hear in the media, what we hear in the news, and what we hear people saying, and the death rates, and how and what happened to people. Now, a lot of things happens to people. Not necessarily all those things must happen to you. Praise the Lord. Especially if you're a believer of Jesus Christ, you should know that you are different. Amen. You are different. Why? Because Jesus dwells in you. The Holy Spirit dwells in you. Amen. Now, stop fearing coronavirus. Hallelujah. I had coronavirus myself in the second wave just last month. And you can look at me how I am beaming with the life of Jesus. Praise God. The day one, I got my report positive. The very next day, you know, I just spent 2 hours praying and confessing the word. Of course, I was taking medicine, whatever is required, but it's just 24 hours. And I took a detailed report from one of the best labs in the city of Bangalore. And I had a detailed report coming with negative, negative, and negative in 3 parameters. You know, God willing, I will share even my test reports with you guys in the coming testimony videos. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you that I'm here as a living testimony. Amen. So all that you need to do is stop fearing this virus and start seeing that God has already made you bigger than coronavirus. Hallelujah. God has put the coronavirus under your feet. Amen. Hallelujah. So the enemy may come against you. A Goliath may come against the nation. A sickness may come. A plague may come. But dear friend, you are seated with Christ in the heavenly places. You don't have to worry. Even if you have sinned, God has an open arms to receive you if only you could repent and run back to Him and confess your sins. Your sins will be forgiven. The blood of Jesus will cleanse you. And there, the power of God will begin to flow into your life. Dear friends, God loves you and me so much that He gave His only begotten Son to be killed, beaten, crushed, bleed and die for you and me. If God would give His Son Jesus to be crushed and bleeding and die for you and me, will God not save you and me from coronavirus? Hallelujah. You know, all kinds of diseases have come into the world, cancers and AIDS and all kinds of things. and God has healed all kinds of sickness and disease. Corona is just an addition to the footstool of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So my friends, cheer up. Maybe you are infected, maybe your loved one, your spouse, your children, maybe they are in your home and you might be the primary contact or you might be the one infected. Listen to me. Stop fearing this worm. Stop fearing this little virus. Hallelujah. What can it do to you? It cannot take your life. It has no authority to take your life. It has no authority to rob your health. It has no authority to eat your wealth. Now listen to me. Coronavirus is a defeated enemy. Coronavirus is defeated 2,000 years back on the cross. It's just another virus. It's just another virus. Jesus paid the price 2,000 years back for it. And you and I are exempted from every plague. We are exempted from sickness. You and I have the authority to live a sickness-free life. So stop fearing coronavirus and start fighting against it. Put up a fight. Refuse to accept it. Reject it. The Bible says, submit to God and resist the devil and he will flee. Hallelujah. We read in Ephesians chapter 6 that in the evil day, put on the whole armor and take the shield of faith and quench every fiery dart of the enemy. See, there is an evil day. Hallelujah. So don't be overwhelmed by the fact that you're infected or your loved one is, or maybe you lost your loved one. Don't be overwhelmed by these things. Maybe your body is infected with coronavirus. Maybe you got a positive report. Don't be overwhelmed by the fact, because the Bible also agrees in the world there is tribulation. There is an evil day. Put on the whole armor. Resist the devil and he will flee. That means he will come for you. So it's all right that you have been infected, but it's not all right that you fear this little virus. Know this, that you belong to Jesus. You were purchased with the blood of Jesus Christ, and no virus has the power to take your life. It has no legal right to take your life. It has no legal right to take your health and rob your health. Your body belongs to God. It is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So put up a fight. Refuse to accept it. Pray every day. Confess the word. Take Holy Communion. Partake in the Holy Communion. Take your medicines. Bless it. Bless your food and eat it. You will be out of this very, very, very soon. Praise God. You will be sickness free. You will have your negative report and you will be healthy. You will not have any of those after effects of coronavirus or after effects of the medicines. No way. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. So my friend, stop fearing this. Rather, make coronavirus fear you. Hallelujah. Make coronavirus fear you. Amen. So I believe you're encouraged, you're inspired to pray and to capitalize your position in Christ. Amen. This is the right time to use every promise that you have in the Word. Believe it, speak it, manifest it. Amen. You will come out with a glorious testimony. And please write to me in the comments as and when you get your negative report and glorify God. Hallelujah. Let me just pray with you. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you that the Word of God says that the enemy, Satan, the devil, is under our feet. We read in the book of Mark chapter 16 that in the name of Jesus, we can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Father, I pray for those who are infected with coronavirus and their family members, the primary contacts. I speak in Jesus' name that they be healed by the supernatural power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit God. The resurrection power that raised Christ from the dead is now touching their body and vitalizing the body, causing every virus to burn under the fire of the Holy Spirit. And Lord, that negative reports come in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, I pray that they will not have any after effects of medicines or the virus itself, that they will come out with double portion of health. Double portion of health, that they'll come with peace. Today, I rebuke every fear in the hearts of your people, and I speak the peace of God and the confidence that our God loves us and he will never ever leave nor forsake us. Father, we will have testimony just according to Acts chapter 10 verse 38, as Jesus went about healing and delivering all those who are oppressed by the devil. Once again, Jesus is doing that for these people who we are praying with right now. Every one of them will be healed and every one of them will be restored. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you for watching. God bless you. If you are new to this channel, I would request you to go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Press the bell icon so that you get notified every time we post our videos. Also, please visit our church channel called Higher Life TV. There you can access our Sunday sermons and be blessed with them as well. I will see you again with another inspiration video. Till then, walk with Jesus. Don't fear corona. Trample corona under your feet. Amen. God bless you.